it's Kristen with LifeMoreAbundantBlog.com, and today I have some container inspiration for you. So the days have been warming up just slightly where I live, and we're still in the freeze zone though, so we can't do too much in the garden, but these plants will kind of hold us over until springtime comes. So we're going to get started just by filling our pots up with, I use this Espoma organic potting soil. This is my favorite, but any type of potting soil will do. So our first plant is going to be a taller one once it starts to bloom. So we're going to start with that, and it's a yellow snapdragon, and we're just going to stick it near what will be the back of the container. Also, it is important to note that the plants that we're putting in the pot today can all handle a light frost, but nothing too heavy. So if you live in a zone where you're still getting a lot of snow or lots of frost, these would probably not be the best for you unless you're going to take them in at night when it freezes. So I'm planting up two pots, and so in order to keep this budget friendly, something that I've been doing for years is buying one pot, like you see here of the Dusty Miller, and separating them. So this one actually had three individual plants within the pot. And some of them, sometimes they don't even have individual plants, and you can still get away with separating their roots like this. And in my experience, it has never done any damage to a plant. So obviously you get a smaller plant if you do this, but it will fill up your container and you only are paying, you know, like this pot was $6.99 at my local garden center. So it's a lot cheaper that way. And like I said, I've never had one have any issue. It acts like nothing ever happened. Same thing with this pansy. I'm gonna separate it. This one did have two different varieties of pansy within it, and I just kind of look for where the separation is and just as gently as I can pull it apart. Sometimes you have to kind of work with it, but it's very doable, and it, in my experience, like I said, has never done any damage to the plant, and it's a really good way to fill up a pot on a budget. This video, and I hope it inspires you to get some pots and fill them with some pretty flowers for your front porch. Thank you so much for watching.